on the road again. It's 8:30 in the morning. I've already been up since 6:30, 7. I went to breakfast at 7 this morning at the hotel because, as you guys know, I struggle with social anxiety every once in a while, often. I decided to try to go to breakfast early too, because this is one of the situations that makes me really anxious and very uncomfortable. So I tried to go early to see if there wouldn't be as many people, and it was very nice and quiet. I've had breakfast, I've left the hotel, and now we're headed to Oberknude, which you have no idea what that is, but I will show you. It's a huge sand dune with a lighthouse. This should be really nice. I tried to go there last year as well, twice actually, but I just couldn't explore because it was so windy. The sand was whipping me and flying in my eyes and in my ears. It was impossible to even stand there for 5 minutes. So I'm hoping today will be a little bit better, and I'm so excited. So I will catch up with you guys when we get there and show you around. So we have arrived at Oberknude. In front of me, behind you guys, I can see the lighthouse and the sand dune, and I'm really excited to get up there. So you actually park a little bit outside because obviously this is right on the beach. So you park and you walk for like 10 minutes, you pass some sheep because it's the summer so they're out. And it's a very nice walk as well. And then you get to the sand dune, you can climb around. I think it's gonna be pretty rough. It's pretty big. Okay, guys, I've made it to the top of the lighthouse. The view here is incredible. I'm so happy. You can actually just walk in, and only one group is allowed at a time because of the current situation. So you get it all to yourself, and it's completely free. You can just walk in. But I'm gonna enjoy the view here, take a few pictures, and just take it all in. It is so cool here. So I'm here at the sand dune. I've just taken a few pictures that I will show you guys. And now I think I will wander around the sand dune a little bit more because I want to take in every view that I possibly can. And then we're gonna probably head on to the next spot because I've already been here for like 2-3 hours. Time flies when you're having fun. Okay, guys, so we are done at Oberknude. I'm back in the car, obviously. Now we're heading on to Bulbär, which is also a place I've been last year. I'll insert a picture here. This is probably going to be my favorite stop, so I'm really excited. But before we go, I'm going to see on the navigation if I can find a supermarket on the way because I need a coffee. And I thought about buying some lunch that I could eat on the beach, which would be super nice. So we're gonna go, I don't know what I'm looking for. We're gonna get on the road, find a supermarket, get some food and some coffee, and then we'll head to Bulbär. Okay, you guys, we are in some random small town near Bulbärg. I've just been to Bulbärg. Bulbär. I've just been to the supermarket. I bought some chicken tandoori wraps and I found a latte macchiato coffee, iced coffee. Iced coffee. And also this risifuti, it's like a rice pudding with strawberry jam. This is classic in Denmark. I missed it so much. It was like, it's kind of nostalgic for me, so that's why I bought it. And I thought it'll be a little dessert. I also found some wrapping paper with the Danish flag on it, and I don't know why I bought it, but I know I'll use it. That's everything I bought, a little supermarket haul for you guys. But now it's time to keep driving. guys. I'm a little bit out of breath, but it's actually really easy to get from the ocean up to the top. You just follow the path and there's a few stairs and you can easily get on top. Wow, guys, I could seriously build a house and live on that cliff. I'm not even joking. I don't know what it is. This place just does something to my soul. So it's actually, I need to put the sweater off because I'm sweating. It's so hot. It's so weird today because the wind is quite cold, so you start freezing, but then the sun is really hot. It's about 3:30. That means we have time for another place. I have one in mind. It's called Beaubear. It's also here on the west coast, but it's 2 hours away. This place is actually a place I've never been before, so I don't know what to expect. I'm thinking it's pretty similar to here. It's supposed to be some sand cliff formation right on the coast, but we'll see together, I guess. I haven't been there, I don't know what to expect, so I guess we'll find out together. I really hope they have a bathroom because I really need to pee. But I'm going to get on the road, put some nice music on, and just drive for 2 hours. Welcome to Beaubear. It is stunning here. I'm so impressed. I cannot believe this landscape. How did we not know this existed in Denmark? That's beyond me. So I just flew around the drone. From what I could see on my phone, it just looks beautiful. I cannot wait to show you guys. So hopefully you enjoy all the clips from the gimbal that I'm using the entire day and also from the drone. All of this new gear is really paying off. I'm loving the way that the vlogs are turning out. So if you can see behind me, there's a pretty dark cloud. So I think I'm gonna head up again. That way I'm near the car in case it starts raining. But I think I'm gonna stay here until sunset because that's gonna be beautiful. So yeah, we're gonna head up and enjoy the views from up there. It doesn't really matter where you go in this place. It's stunning everywhere. By the way, in case you're wondering, the gimbal I was talking about is this one, the DJI Osmo Mobile 3. I just bought it before this trip and it's amazing. Like, it's so easy to use, it's so smooth, and it just creates the most beautiful clips. I mean, you've probably seen already most of like the little vlog style clips are filmed on this one. You just pop your phone into this thing on the top and connect it with the app, and it's awesome. Also, in case I didn't say, it's about 6 o'clock right now and I think sunset will be in about 2 hours, so maybe I'll get on my computer, go in the car and get on my computer, start editing a little bit, because I don't know what I'm supposed to do for 2 hours. I've already been here for a while, but I'm definitely staying, so we'll see how we get on.